here with the Untitled Game
like
Show.
We finally got a shot at
Let's go ahead and stream some XCOM 2. It's been a long time since I streamed something from Shadowplay, so I do apologize off the bat if there are any damn problems, because I'm pretty sure I'm going to make some mistakes. Anyways, what's going to be happening today is I'm going to show you an extremely modded version of XCOM 2 with a lot of things you can't have in the normal game. So first and first, we're going to go into the research department right here, guys. And you guys are going to see these advent lock boxes. These lock boxes are from like Grimmie's, it basically turns Diablo-style loot into XCOM 2. So you basically be able to unlock them through here. You have like an MCN menu into the settings right here. It's a mod menu, so you can change up the settings right here. It's called Grimmie's Loot Mod. Basically, you see what type of loot you mostly kind of get. Weapons, armors, how fast it gets to unlock them, and so on and so forth. I also have a mod in there for brand new maps, how the maps interact with enemies, and a lot of other things like that related. But we're here to play some really difficult XCOM 2. Right now, I am playing on a very hard difficulty. I am playing on Commander difficult. That's one down below Legendary, which Legendary is basically insane. So we're going to keep it on Commander for right now. I'm definitely past veteran because I've been playing XCOM for a while now. So, and we have some pretty powerful characters and new classes that we're going to be showing you. So first and first,
I await your orders,
we're
going
to go ahead
Commander.
And set ourselves to decrypt this. It's going to take a day.
I foresee a number.
Then we're going to go in the map and we're going to go ahead and choose our missions for
this.
So I already have two targets set up. We have one that's very difficult and then we have one right here that's difficult. We're going straight to the very difficult. We got 19 enemies detected. I also have a mod installed right now that tells
you
basically how many enemies are on the mission and what type of weapons and stuff. So some of the mods I have do give you a lot of extra information you don't get from the basic game. And like I have a larger squad than normal. And to counteract this, I've installed a lot of mods to make it a lot harder for myself, like better AI, more pods, really strong enemies, really elite enemies that you normally wouldn't get in the game. So I'm just going to press autofill right now. It's going to autofill my squad, but I'm going to have to take out some of these characters right here because I already know some of them I'm not going to use. But some of these guys you already seen are brand new classes, like her right here. She's a new type of sniper. She wasn't in the regular class. This guy right here is a new type of class. And you guys will be able to see by just looking at this. I even have a class that's called a necromancer, so I'll be able to bring other characters back to life as zombies and all type of crazy stuff. So let me just go ahead and just do some stream stuff real quick before we jump into this mission that's gonna be pretty darn difficult. So I'm just gonna right now what I'm actually doing is I'm just switching over to make sure that I got the live feed from the stream so that way I could actually interact with everybody in chat. So just give me a moment to have everybody updated on what's actually going on. And then once I do that, we will go ahead and jump in and have some fun with XCOM 2. All right, guys. So it's going to be a pretty difficult mission. Just don't get that twisted. It's going to be pretty darn hard to accomplish and win, but my characters are pretty darn powerful. So once again, welcome to everybody in chat. Desktop, go fuck yourself. Cool. So can everybody hear me okay? How's the audio? Well, I know the audio is good right now because I'm outside of the game. But I'm just right to chat real quick. I'm not doing face cam right this second, but I will have face cam up very soon. All right, guys. So there we go. You guys let me know how everything is. Your channel is pretty dope. Well, thank you, like a boss. So here we go, guys. I don't stream very much, guys, so I'm going to let you guys know right off the bat. I am not a normal streamer. I've gotten away from streaming on Twitch and YouTube, but I've just been playing this game so much that I said it's about time, and I've been asked by other YouTubers, like, I need to show my mods. Like, and let's go through some of them right now. So first thing first, we're going to show you some of the mod classes that I have real quick. So here's one right here. He's an infantry class. The infantry class is a new class to XCOM. He's extremely good all-around soldier type class. Like an infantry, he's good at being able to defend, protect, mark out targets, and he's also a commander, which I get from the leader pack for the mods. And I will have a full mod list in the description. This is XCOM 2. So Tim's is cool. This is XCOM 2, guys. It's going to be extremely hard. I'm just going to do some quick overview stuff before we get in the mission. And I'm telling you, if you're watching this right now, wait around for the mission. You will see the difficulty. I am playing this on basically higher than veteran, commander difficulty. But I just want to explain some of the new classes. So this is a mod right here that was not in a class that was not in the base game. It is called Infantry. Highly recommend this one right here. Here's another mod that was not in the regular game. This is called the Shock Trooper. This guy's main thing is using flame-based weapons. Very good class right here, right? Let's keep on moving over here. Here's a samurai mod. The samurai mod is more about having very great mobility and be able to kill enemies multiple times to get extra moves. She's basically been my most powerful character throughout the whole entire game because her mobility makes her strong. She got plus 19 plus 6 mobility, guys. That is insane. She runs rolling the whole entire map. All right, next up, guys, another modded class right here, the sniper. This is a different type of sniper than all the other sharpshooters in the game. Very powerful, but it's more about setting up. The sniper finds its position high up on the map and keeps that position locked down. She doesn't move around a lot. She sets up and waits for a target to go in her line of sight, and then she takes it out. It's a very interesting class, highly recommended. Let's move on from here. Here's another samurai. Don't need to show another one. Here's a necromancer, my favorite new class, because the necromancer is freaking insane, guys. This thing could bring other dead enemies back to life. So those crazy abilities that you have seen from the enemies in XCOM 2, this guy could bring enemies back to life and you could control them as zombies. And he has this thing called a death touch, which basically means when he touches somebody, he rips the freaking soul out of their body and kills them instantly. It's nuts. It's hard to pull off because he's not a character that gets very close to anybody, but it's very cool. Moving on from there, the medic, my second favorite new class. It's so simple. A guy that just prioritizes medic. This dude is so important when it comes to playing on a harder difficulty. His ability to heal and keep his teammates alive is unbelievable, and stuff like debilitate, which neutralizes enemy movement, is so useful, which I'll explain all this while we're in the mission. And here we go, the nutty, nutty, crazy guy, you guys. Well, girl, you see in the thumbnail. She has a burned face because I feel like she's like my Joker-type character, as you guys will be able to see right here. Let me go into her face. I gave her a burn face right here, and the makeup's basically covering that burn. She is the one who doesn't use a gun. This is probably the most unique class I've seen out there because all she used is a grenade launcher. She has no guns, and she has limited amount of grenades. Her whole entire thing is just use grenades to help out her team. So plasma the grenades, frost bombs. So for this mission right now, I'm going to go with a... My second grenade is going to be a... A gas grenade or acid grenade? We're going to do the acid bomb. Acid bomb sheds armor. So we have frost bomb, which is from the DLC. That's going to be instantly be able to freeze enemies. And now I'm going to hook her up as well. She has a rocket launcher on her arm. We're going to hook her up with this with a plasma blaster. This is like a guided bomb that blows everything up. So she's all about destruction. And she also has a gremlin, which kind of helps her out for hacking as well. So really cool class. Very unique. I've never seen anything like that before in XCOM. And it's really cool to be able to have that. So anyways, guys, those are some of the new classes. That's not all of them, but we're just going to get into the mission right now. So we're going to start off with Heavy Rain. That's my main girl right here, like calling Heavy Rain for that game. Then we're going to throw up here. We have Green Arrow. Green Arrow, obviously, is wearing green. He uses a battle scanner, and he's the one who's the necromancer. His character trait is to be twitchy, so he's always moving around. Next up from that, we're going to be using the character right here, Emily, who is the Arcan. She's basically my grenader right there, guys. Not grenader, but something else. The healer, I'm going to change my voice to my healer because also in this mod, guys, I'm not talking about just enemies. I'm not just talking about looks. I am talking to the voice packs too. So let me go character information. We're going to go to voice. So his voice right now is Snake from Metal Gear Solid. So I'll let you guys hear some of that. Let me know how the audio is too.
You got some kind of plan?
Got it.
I'm ready to go. For you to say.
Yeah, he takes his soul, guys.
I get it.
It's your decision. Lectures.
So this is Metal Gear Solid Snake. That's Zero from Borderlands, but he's not saying much. This is Max Payne.
I still had other problems to deal with.
That's Max Payne.
Ready or not, here we go.
That's Sergeant Armstrong from Metal Gear Solid, what's called, the former one with Raiden.
Wow, this is a really bad idea.
Brock Samson, if you guys know Brock Samson from the Adult Swim cartoon. And then, you know, Team Fortress 2 Medic.
Marshall.
But the newest one, Adam Jensen, Jack O'Neill, Emperor Palpatine. Emperor Palpatine is who I made, oh my god, Emperor Palpatine's the best shit ever if you put him on the psychic class. Alright, guys, and we got McCree's voice from Overwatch. So the newest one I just added, where is it? Let me see.
What my brilliant aura.
Oh yes, Solia of Arthur. So this is Dark Soul. That's the newest voice I just added. So I wanted to see what the Dark Soul voices sound like. All right, guys, let's get out of this and get into the mission. Let's pick all my characters. So right here we got ourselves. So this guy right here, I'm gonna explain to him in a second. So these two costumes I have right here have the most abilities. This one is basically a big-ass hulking costume. Make her be able to smack the shit out of everybody. She is a psychic operative, basically, so she's pretty damn strong. This guy right here, he has the ability to fly around. Really cool armor once again. This was actually in DLC armor. Extremely overpowered, but these enemies I'm about to fight is going to make up for that like the power. My character is pretty damn beasty. This guy right here is, you can't see him on the thing until I go into it because that's a mod. Once again, I have extra characters. He's an officer class. So one thing about this class, I can't change his armor. He's only has this armor. But what he does is so cool. He basically is an officer that supports his teammates. He could make one of his teammates be Black Ops. Once you set a teammate to be Black Ops, that teammate could go out there and just be the baddest ass character. Better dodge, better movement. It just really powers up a teammate. So he's basically the leader of the team below the commander, which is another person above them who has all the... And then he has this thing called Request Airstrike. The airstrike is so powerful that it takes 2 turns to activate, so it really balances out. So you have to actually time out when you actually activate this airstrike. And he has energy shield, which I'm gonna show you guys this immediately. Stick around to me, everybody here. You guys are gonna see some shit in XCOM that's gonna be like crazy. If you have not, if you've seen people use mods before, I'm telling you, I have over 60 mods. I think I'm rocking at 80 mods in this game, guys. I have a folder with like 2 gigs of just mods. Like the mods installed right now are nutty. So last, we're gonna add in one more other class. I'm just see who else I'm gonna add. I'm not gonna do the infantry. I don't use infantry anymore. I don't use a fire guy anymore. I don't use a sniper for these missions. I'm gonna go ahead and use Fury. Fury right now. Fury is another new kind of class. I like him. He's really powerful, but he's kind of unpredictable. So I don't want to use him. Let's use the Brewster. The Brewster Dolly, she's my commander. So she is another new type of class. She uses shotgun and she's efficient. And I'm not a person that's very much into shotguns, but that's what I use. And if you guys are wondering why the colors of the weapons are different from the armor, it's because the weapons I have for them, which I'll just show you this, is another mod. So now with the loot pack that I have from Grimmy's Loot Mod actually gives you mods that actually give you super powered weapons. And the mods, the weapons that drop from the enemies could have different stats. So this one has a super ability that makes grazes chances, basically decreased graze chances by 30%, which is really good for that type of weapon. And as you guys see right here, I have a regular beam pistol, but instead of using the regular beam pistol, I could click on this and have this called Necro Pistol. This Necro Pistol has special abilities on the right side where it says Advanced Suppressor. All these weapons have different stats, which you normally don't see in XCOM. We got the Blast Launcher. I could change these to whatever I need to have. So all the weapons I have, all the characters all have different abilities. And as you guys will see, I'll try to show you something. Like, yeah, the yellow weapons are the rarest. So you have yellow weapons, they're super powerful. That's what these are. And even down to your amps could have different abilities as 12. But it's really rare to get these things right here, guys. It's really rare. So here we have some stuff right here. The Gremlin even can have it too. So there's a lot of different possibilities with this stuff. Hellfire, these are all advanced. So there we go, guys. That's gonna be my crew. Let's go ahead and fly out and we're gonna face this hard-ass mission. Sorry it took so long to introduce everything, but I want to make sure you guys are clear on what we're getting into and how hard, so I can explain it a lot better once we're actually on the mission. Let's see what's going on in chat. Yes, this is XCOM 2. It's coming to consoles later this year. This is the PC version, and I'm hoping to... Because I play the shit out of this game.
The Resistance has been pulling data critical to the aliens' latest project from the Advent Network using something they rigged up in this area. As far as we can tell, the aliens have figured out what's going on and they're sending reinforcements in to destroy the device. We're moving in to secure the area and protect the device before they manage to take it out.
This is going to be pretty hard because we have to protect the device. Let me see what's it. He takes their souls. The game is locked. The game looks cool. Snake voice is best. Also, guys, the game's not glitchy with the mods. Oh, no. I have a pretty powerful computer. I'm running. You guys might be able to see my frame rate in the top left-hand corner. I'm actually running this at higher than 1080p. I'm running this at 1440p ultra settings. I do have anti-aliasing off because my monitor still looks pretty decent and I'm streaming. And I'm getting about 60. I'll drop down into the low 49s, but right now I'm getting a consistency 64 frames. I have it on the screen. You guys can see my frame rate. I'm getting 64 frames. I'm streaming this to YouTube at 30 FPS 1080p, but I am playing at 1440p. I would play at 4K, but because I'm streaming this at the same exact time, I have all my... my temperatures are up right now. Like right now my graphics card is running at 80 Celsius, 1300 megahertz. But point being, let's get into the fun. Let's see what we got to do right here. We got to protect this device from the aliens. So remember, guys, this won't be easy. So first thing first, I'd like to do with this guy right here, because he's a shield bearer, we're going to move him up a little bit, and then you guys will be able to see it right here. No, not him. That's my medic. Wrong mistakes right there. We'll just put him on Sentinel Overwatch. Wrong guy. We're going to start off with our... Here we are. Yes, here we are. Gonna start off with him right here.
Let's get a move on.
Now normally I start off with a battle scanner, but I want to show you guys this stuff right here. So watch this. Energy shield. So you guys know those energy shields that the enemies always get? Why can't my units get the enemy shields? That's what that's all about. So next thing I usually normally do with a situation like this, where you know you're going to have to defend something, you know what the enemies are going to be. You might be concealed right now. I like to move him out real quick, and then let's start getting an area view. So we're going to use a battle scanner. The battle scanner, what it does, I throw it out, and in this fog area right here, it's going to let me be able to see what's out there. So, woo, we got some really strong enemies right here. So here we go. Anybody who knows XCOM knows that enemy we just saw. So this guy right here, hold on, let me throw it again. I want to make sure you guys see this right here. This guy right here is the basically the commander, the man-o-man, the guy from the main story, but a corrupt version. Him right here, he's a new enemy. He is the strongest enemy in the game. Fucking the strongest. Like, from my experience, the strongest. But we're going to take him out, and we're going to watch how we're going to do this right here, right? Remember, once again, I just want to make sure everybody's clear on this shit. This is commander difficulty, one down to legendary. So it's a very... I just don't want to lose completely, so that's why I'm not playing a legendary. So here's what we're going to do right here, guys. We're going to have to play this very smart. So we're going to go start over here.
Stand down.
Now what you're going to see right here, this is called draw fire. This is going to make it so that all enemies, if they do attack, they're going to fire at her. And she's a very good amount of survivability. So that's what that's about right there, right? Now if I use the Icarus jump right now, that's going to give my position away. So we're going to wait on that. But we're going to have a very cool thing to do with that real soon. These two characters are the main characters for the strategy you're about to see real quick. So right here, my Rage Girl. Now, you guys might be wondering why some of my characters can't move that far. Well, they actually have double movements, meaning they have multiple action points because the weapons allow that, but at a cost is the fact that...
Understood.
Sorry. It's the fact that they have reduced movement. So here we are. So he can't move yet. She can move. Alright, so here's how we're going to destroy this guy. So this girl right here, my grenader basically, I know she's not a grenader, they haven't done a name for her, but she only uses grenades, so it's a good number. She's going to be able to use her frost bombs. This is from the DLC. I need to get a little closer. Shit. I need to be a little closer. Only going to freeze one of them. Alright, so we need to do something else. So alright, so it's not enough distance. So this is where I'm going to have to change my strategy. So that's the one problem with this, my setup, is like I reduce a lot of my movements initially, but then I can use stuff like Inspire. Inspire is a psychic ability that gives my teammate more movement. So this is going to let her move one more time. Alright. So here we go. We're going to all set this all up. It's not going to be as simple as it seems, but... it will give us a very good base to start. Now, this might not be the best start, but I'm trying to show you guys what these stuff do.
Commander,
off the bat.
I believe we are seeing something entirely new. An alien species that has so far managed to elude capture or observation by resistance forces. I strongly advise a cautious approach.
All right, here we go. So this frost bomb right here is going to freeze all these three targets.
There.
So there we go. We're going to press enter, send that out. And it's going to reveal my whole entire team. So the enemies now know where I am. But here's where the fun actually begins. Because remember, she has 19 movement. She is my killer. So this is where, even if they see me, it's going to be okay. So she has this ability right here, which is adds a shield. So she's going to add even more shield. Boom, as you guys see right there, her shield, her damage is, her shield's all the way up. And then she has this also other ability. If she kills somebody, the next attack at her is not going to kill her. So right there, she just killed somebody, right? That's very important. Now, I'm going to show you. Damn, man, I can't get closer. Damn, they were really far away. I was going to try to kill them all in one hit from her. She has this ability called right here, what's called Dragon Strike, that could kill a whole entire group of enemies at once. But because I can't get close enough right now, I'm just going to go into a defensive position.
Heading out.
They're all frozen right now, so I should be good for one more turn, unless they thaw out. And no other aliens. See, I'm moving slow, too, because I don't want other alien pods to activate. And what alien pods mean is basically, like, how many aliens could see you. All right, here we go. Here we go. So Dragon Strike, with this, she's going to do an area effect sword swing. So that hits all three of them right there. And then watch what the Necromancer could do.
Hostile target down.
So here's my Necromancer, right? We're gonna move him up here. I'm not gonna be able to do the soul grab, like I said, guys. It's very hard to get him close enough. But he has this really cool ability right here. Now, it's gonna might be able to hit her because I'm close, but she actually has the ability to be immune to poison and fire and all those stuff. So he does this, which is a really great area effect attack. It sends out poison, burn, and acid all across the ground. So here we are. This is where my medic is gonna move up a little bit.
Why not help one another on this lonely journey?
He has the ability to run and gun, which I'm not gonna use right here. So this is where we're gonna actually start being a little bit more strategic, and we're gonna use his ability to fly. Now, I obviously know there's gonna be enemies up here, but I'm still gonna go up here with the Icarus jump because just getting a higher view of the map is gonna be very useful. So he flies up here. Oh, shit! Oh, damn. I knew there was gonna be some enemies up here, but I never explained there to be that many. That is a lot of enemies. Holy shit, that's a lot of enemies. They're literally surrounding my character. What is going on right now? What is going on? Holy snap. I expected it. Okay, so this is what happens when you install a bunch of enemy mods and just all type of crazy enemies and get yourself surrounded. So in a situation like this, I could do a few different things. And one of them is this. Could actually damage myself. Hear me out. Well, some of you guys are like, why am I damaging myself? Well, don't worry.
Destroy me.
Alright. This has a lot of extra effects too. So he's panicked right there. Anybody got hit by this gets a lot of extra effect. So how am I going to save that guy up here? Well, you guys are going to see that in a second. So like all we know, all that's happening up there. We're going to turn some Black Ops shit in. So we're going to set one of my characters to be a Black Ops agent. So he's the Black Ops agent right there. Put him over, her over here. So. Almost.
Crumble!
I really didn't expect there to be so many enemies up here, but we could take care of it. I'm just gonna freeze my own guy. Wait, actually, I don't have to do that yet. Let me see how close she is. If I could find one person, where is she on the map? Here she is. Okay, she's right here. Good stuff.
It's my
turn. So she's going to use this ability right here, which is called Fall Back. So she's a commander. She could tell her teammates to get back to safety. So she's going to, even though this guy's out of move, I'm going to be able to order him to get out of trouble. It says grants a free action, but I'm not controlling the action. So I can't control this, but he's going to automatically know to get out of trouble. So he's going to run away and try to find somewhere safe to be. So he went inside the building, which is perfectly fine. So now, which what I was about to do a second ago was kind of dumb. With her, I can send out the frost grenade and freeze all these enemies in place.
External factor.
Alright, so the whole entire squad is frozen right there. Then, I need him to move again. I want to show you guys what the area effect explosion could do.
I'm willing to take the chance.
If I can. So I'm going to go ahead and expire him with her. So grant an extra move to the commander. Or the officer leader. So now that he has an extra move, see how far, I can't throw. This is that two turn, a really great explosion I was talking about. So for right now, we're just gonna move this over here, move him up, so I can get him a little closer, maybe I'll use it another turn. So he taught out, But even though he's tore down, he's still standing in all the acid and everything. So he's going to get poisoned. Those guys are going to still be frozen. He's going to get burning. And he should get acid burn too if he hasn't already got that. And that guy's panicked down there, so he shouldn't attack my peoples. So that's what I try to do. I try to keep them locked down for on their turn so they can't hurt my team. That's the whole strategy. So here he goes. Let's see what type of craziness he's going to do. Untouchable. That's what's so great about Untouchable. Whatever shit he was about to do didn't work because of Untouchable. So here we go. Here's where we're going to have some fun, guys. This is just me showing you some of the abilities. I'm not staying in cover. I'm not playing as smart as I should be. But here's that air orbital strike, basically. It's going to fuck up this building. But remember, guys, it takes a turn to actually happen. So in that sense, this is why I made her Black Ops once again. So we're just going to go up right here. I'm just going to stay up and open. And I'm going to throw out another. I'm wasting my last frost bomb. I only have 3 members. She has a limited amount of grenades. But the reason for this is I want to make sure that all these guys are here for when the present comes. Let me turn the camera around. Here we go.
Shallow.
So you guys can see the destructive ability of that overflow. So here we go. Keep them frozen. And the guy that I had over here, him, we're going to have him move back right here.
Once more, the Sith.
He's the guy with the Emperor Palpatine voice. Hey, what's up to Sonicit Gamers? Hello, guys. This is XCOM 2 with a lot of mods on a very high difficulty. We're going to use his ability right called Dedication. With Dedication, it lets him run a lot farther for 2 turns. And also, we're going to use Run and Gun because I'm not going to be able to reach my guy right here very good. But I can still run up here. And even though he is a medic, he has this very cool ability. Well, he has a very cool gun, I should say. It's called a shadow pistol. If I kill somebody with this pistol, it makes him go back in concealed. So watch this. So concealment is very important. But this guy, this character is a very strong enemy. It resurrects itself as a zombie even after it dies. Isn't that crazy, guys?
The aliens have found a way to mind control them now.
So I go back concealed, but I get flanked. Just wanted to show you guys this guy. So either ways, I'm going to be able to kill him right here. Actually, before we do that, let's have somebody else help with that. We're going to go ahead and use the shredder gun. So shredder gun's a pretty cool gun.
I think I can handle it, sir.
Here's what it does.
We all know it's an extreme long shot, sir.
It's basically a long-distance shotgun. Let's see what else I can show you guys. She has this right here, which is called... Let me move up.
Pray!
She's the one with the shotgun, so I just want to get a little higher. Also, everybody in her range, this is called the commander range, so... Everybody in her range gets different abilities because she is the leader. So everybody around her, that gets a little bit more defense, a little bit more aim. So if you stay inside this grid right here, it helps you out as a team. And that range, how big this range is, it's all affected by like how like much levels you've gotten. But everybody in my team right now is at the max level. So right now we're going to use this thing called the taser shot. This you normally use against robots, but I just want to show you guys what it looks like right now for anybody watching. Right there. Normally, if it was a robot, do more damage, and it could even like stun living enemies. So right here, as you guys, oh man, still can't kill him. Sorry. So we're gonna use one of her abilities right here, and we're gonna hope we get a critical. Get a critical, perfect, 19 damage. So she can stand in the acid just fine because her immunities.
X-ray neutralized.
That's her way for a samurai. That was one of her, basically one of her abilities. Are like, yep, I'm a samurai. I'm fucking too good to get poisoned. Can't fuck with me with poison, man. Like the samurai is like, yo, son, I poison myself so I learn. I gain immunity to this shit. So right here, now she can move again because she killed somebody. But we're not going to move over here. Remember, if I moved over here, I'm basically going to kill my own people. So what I'm going to do right here is just wait right where I am. I don't want to move any farther yet because obviously if I move farther, I am going to be able to make it so that enemies are going to be able to see me. But what I'm going to show you guys right now is the Necromancer's ability to raise zombies. So now that really powerful guy I just killed, I could literally bring him back as my own zombie. So raise your fucking zombie. You're not mine. You're my zombie. So there you go. He gets raised back up. I hope I targeted the right one. It's kind of hard to see with all the... I picked the wrong one. It doesn't matter. I picked him back up. So this guy right now is my own character. So now I control him as a zombie. So here's where I'm going to end my turn. The shields are not permanent. Those shields that are around the characters, they're not permanent. So they're going to move away right now. Shit, I got to go level 10. Oh, later, man. So the enemy, the enemy's taught out. No, they're gonna move. Wait, let's see what's going on right here. Damn, they're moving. Only damn, it's only one damage grazed. Oh, so see, this is where it gets hard. See, this is what happens. I thought they were gonna be frozen. This is bad. These crystals do a lot of damage. My officer might just die. Shit, that's a lot of damage, man. This is going bad. This is going bad, man. Should have stayed in cover. Oh, a miss. Oh, perfect, man. We got... Damn. Are they, y'all, enemies are smart, man. This is what better AI... That's what better AI is all about. They know just to attack one guy. No, he has one health left. If this does not miss, if this... Oh, perfect. He just goes immune. Oh, shit. Holy shit, you guys. See, and that was it. That was an off. See, the explosion. Look at that explosion. Destroyed half the building. Look at that shit. That's what destructibility is like in this freaking game. Love that. Half the building. If all these enemies were right there when that went off, that building would be demolished. So, very bad move by me. Very bad. Now, some of you guys might be seeing this little round aura around my character right here. This is from the medic. The medic actually emits a field that basically heals teammates. So here's what we're going to use this thing right here. It's called triage. This actually heals teammates around them. So watch this. It heals plus 4. And then what we're going to do with him, we need to get him out of the fire. Man, I thought he was going to die. He's going to get his revenge though. So this is where everything's going to get kind of interesting. So here's where we are. We have the zombie right here. So with the zombie, I could attack with the zombie or I could do this. Called zombie explosion. Where the zombie basically pukes out his guts into acid.
Who's gonna make it?
And it burns everything. Oh shit, I kind of hit my own person. I didn't think it was going to reach her. So right here is where we're going to use Shinigami. And before we actually go in for the main kill, we're going to be killing these guys with some special abilities.
Die.
Not with guns, mostly. But real quick, before we do that, we're going to hack some stuff.
Releasing.
Because once she runs out of grenades, the only thing she can do is send her gremlin out to do stuff. So she does have the ability to hack stuff. So right here, it says, squad recovers all action points already spent. What? Hell yeah! Give me that! What? That's a great hack! Hell yeah! So we get another turn. Alright, so basically all the moves I just made, I can make another move. That is really good. But still. So here's a few things I could do. I could control one of these chrysalis with Dominate, which I haven't done yet, which is basically mind control. But I think this will be more fun to show. This is called Void Rift. But let me move up a little bit. Once again, guys, I am playing very... not the smartest, because I'm not going in the cover. But I'm just making it more excited for the stream. Like, the right way to do is take little turns, slowly but slowly, but... I'll show you some cool stuff, guys. I'll show you some cool stuff. I have a pretty good team. Right there. I got one mind control from using that, so that's a really cool thing.
I would say it was training
burn,
and fortitude.
Died anyways, damn. And then I even could do stuff like frostbite, which is this. I really shouldn't use this right now, but I want to show it. So this is frostbite, which basically tries to freeze an enemy, because he's a snake skin. I missed it. It was 50% chance. It was not a very good chance of hitting. Either way, well, here's lightning bolt. So this basically, here's a lightning bolt. You can make a wizard class with the mods in here. So you can either go necromancer or you can go to wizard. I went with the more necromancer class, but if you wanted to, you could go full on wizard. So because I got those extra movement points right there, now I could go over here and heal this guy. So let's heal back up our officer right here. Because he clearly needs some help. So that's plus 7 for him. We're just gonna start moving people forward. Also, if you wanna see something funny, you could tell how the frame rate reacts. If you guys go to full screen, you could tell how the frame rate reacts to what. Like if you get zoomed in on stuff like explosions and stuff like the fire effects, that's how I like, now I'm under 50 frames when I get zoomed in close to this stuff. Like, but as long as I don't stay too close to this, all this effect right here, the frame rate goes up. Like I'm at 58 frames per second right now at 1440p, drops down to 55. But as long as I move away from that, it's like those effects, I go back over 60. Very interesting. I'm not playing with adaptive sync on right now.
Barely worth my time.
I could have done that, but I just didn't. So right now, let's regroup and actually start playing a little smart. Make sure you guys go ahead and like the video if you like it. I don't stream very much, so if you guys want me to stream more, that's just like how I know. Like that's how I know. Likes, comments, stuff like that. Let's go ahead and overwatch on this. Alright, we're gonna move people up, but I don't want to move people up too much yet.
Capture!
We're gonna do something. This is another way to heal. So she has ability to hurt teammates. But if they survive, they get 7 health. It's a weird ability. So like it does 3 damage to somebody, but
destroyer
if they survive the damage, they get between 3 and 7 health. So I just hurt him for 3. And let's see if that heals him back all the way. I didn't really do much. It just evened out. That's not really great. So now with him. Now here's what's really cool. All right, guys. I didn't show you why I wanted to make this guy survive so much. He has an ability right here called Squad Concealment. Squad gets concealed. Can be used once per mission. It's that powerful. Basically allowing my whole entire squad to go back into concealment. All right, 1 second. I'm back in the game. I just have to do something real quick. All right, there we go. So now we're gonna go into Overwatch right here.
I've got this cover.
Okay. All right. So now that all my squads are concealed, we can start on the way. So some of my classes have grappling hooks. With the grappling hooks, get them higher ground. So we got some enemies over here. Ooh, the black sphere. That sphere is a really powerful one right here. And we got some elite advent officers. Those are, once again, more mods for enemies. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to go into Overwatch. And my goal right now is to control these units. So control the units right there. So first thing first, we're going to get him over here. And we need to get our mind control units in place. See, this is where it gets really tricky. For me to get him to the point where he could actually dominate somebody, he's gonna have to use Icarus Jump. Or I could wait. I know what, I'll wait. I'll play strategic. I'll actually just play smart. And we'll wait one more turn.
The dark side is my ally.
We'll set up first. Love that. I love how that look. Alright. So we're just gonna press Advanced Sentinel Overwatch so in case any enemies were near me. Then we're gonna go right here. No, actually we're gonna go right here.
That's affirmative.
Like there might be enemies right in front of me up here.
Menace 1-5, we've got a line on the target. Move to protect that gear at all costs.
Trust me, I will.
Roger, I've got my eyes on.
So I want to get her up closer. So we're going to move her up here. We're going to switch over to him right here. We're going to move him up here. Hey, what's up, Untitled Game Show? I have a question. Oh, shoot. Shoot, Nico. Nicole, I'm going to call you Nico, if that's okay. What's up? What's your question? If I can't answer it, I will.
It's just begun.
So we're moving him up here. Also, if you guys want to get this game, it's pretty cheap on the Steam Summer Sale. I did pick up some games in the Steam Summer Sale, which I might stream later on today.
You wish to continue?
Pilt Up Tales of Symphonia, because they finally patched that game and fixed a lot of the issues. Oh, they moved! Man, they really are. Better AI is better AI. So they're going to destroy it. Oh, man, they're doing a lot of damage. Crap. We gotta stop them. We have to stop them. So here's where it gets tricky. Here's just where it's gonna get tricky. I was hoping that they stayed still. So right now, the best thing I could do, I need a attack that does multiple area effect. Oh, wait. Domination. Here we go. So I could do both the guys with the swords. Okay, so I can get them dominated. Alright, fine. We're gonna rock it this way. Overwatch.
I've got this cover.
We're gonna do this smart. We're gonna open up a door in the building and have all my guys ready to shoot through that door. Okay, cool. Thanks, man. Thanks. Glad you enjoy the stuff I do. I need to do more of it. That's why I'm streaming, because I don't stream too much these days, so I figured it'd be fun to stream a little.
Are you serious?
Oh, I'm serious. I'm serious, girl. I'm very serious. So you're going to stay right here. You're going to stay right there. So everybody's in position. All right, guys. So this is me setting up right here. So first thing first, if she doesn't move, she can use two bombs. I just need to make sure I don't hit my my objective. But destroying my old objective at this point would be really dumb. So we gotta get the bomb in the right place. Right here. Boom.
The Black Beast. The world's
Check this
nightmare.
Out. It's an extreme heavy weapon, guys. Real good tech. Bam. Now they know where I am.
Mirror of the Imperium!
They're gonna move. Okay, he moves right there. Oh, he's still inside. Couldn't get a reaction shot.
He's a Yoi's power?
Everybody's also individually, Oh, shit, man. No reaction shots. Okay, he does. Okay, I was about to say... Oh, there you go. That guy's doing it. Eight. Got him. I was like, man, none of them are running in my line of fire? So here's where the fun begins, though. Because remember, she has the dominate ability. So this guy right here, which is not... Nah, he's weak already. Let's get somebody. Alright, hold on. Let's have some real fun. Let's blow this wall up.
Perish!
I'm trying to get the big guy. What game is this? This game is XCOM 2. It came out in early February on PC. Hold on, sorry. Man, I can't see through this damn fucking wall. Anybody got I need a plasma grenade. Anybody got a damn plasma grenade I can use real quick, brothers? It's just me thinking strategy real quick, guys, because I need to... It's an incendiary grenade. Not whatever. Let's knock this guy out. That's one of the abilities of that class. And he got poison too. We're gonna put draw fire. So that's gonna protect it. And then I didn't want to do this, But we're going to use Icarus Jump and go over here. We're going to fly over here. This should be still in the cover area. That's if there's no other enemies over here. I don't know if there's enemies over here. But I should be able to use Dominate. Damn, I only got these three guys? I guess I can't use a big guy. I guess you can't dominate him. I guess that guy's that character is way too strong. Alright, so fine. If I can't dominate him, I'll do your pawns then. So I didn't even know this guy was over here.
Give in to your anger.
It came out in February, and since it came out, it has a supported mod. And because this has supported mods from day one, it's created some crazy-ass mods. Some mods I've never seen. So we're gonna put this here.
I think I can handle it, sure.
This is bad. Alright, know what we're gonna do? Soul Flare. We're gonna use Soul Flare. This does guarantees damage. And this could inflict other stats. So guaranteed damage.
We have to concentrate on damage control.
Okay. Let's reload here. He's gonna go right here because that window is right there. That's if he moves going. Through that window. Oh perfect, he did the curse. Damn it, that don't work either. Here we go. We're going to poison him. So Necromancer also has the ability to poison enemies. So that's one of his like really early things. So as a class, that's like really cool. So now that enemy's poisoned. Not the most best use of my abilities, but whatever. Poisons. Does do damage, so it helps. So that's one damage right there. Because this is a Rift Keeper Mark II. He's getting Acid Burn at the same time too, because the Acid Burn was up on top. That guy fucking died because poison. And he was stunned at that too. Oh, there's more enemies. Okay, it's not over. Big mech. Big mech. Whoa. Okay, it just got real. Like I said, guys, commander difficulty. This is some extreme shit right here. They are not playing. They want to destroy this damn thing. Okay, let's go. It's not over. Alright, Overwatch. Miss! Come on, bro. You have the snake skin stuff on. Y'all supposed to be missing?
Crumble!
Oh, crap. Just fucking teleported in fucking reinforcement. I've seen your videos before. Well, thank you, man. Well, shit. Well, I guess I never said it was gonna be easy. I never said... The title does say extreme. Why does it say desktop? Wait. I just realized the stream says desktop. What the fuck is up with that? Oh shit. Why does that happen? Okay, I renamed the stream. Oops. That's so weird. I didn't realize that it had been set desktop this whole entire time. I think because I'm streaming through NVIDIA Experience and I don't use that very much, I didn't know. So that's a mistake on my part right there, guys. So I do apologize for that. I know the screen. I'm gonna go back in the game. I was just wanting to fix that because I really did not know this whole entire time. This shit has said desktop. Like, what kind of dumb shit is that? Desktop, wow. And I've probably been streaming like for an hour. Alright, there we go. That should be able to fix it. Alright, let's get back in the game. That was weird. Desktop. Okay, so now we're in kind of a troubled position. It's a lot more enemies than I expected. So, We need to do something about this. We need to dominate something useful. That's not going to be useful. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to use Null Lancer. Null Lancer is basically, it projects a beam of psionic energy that damages everything in its path. So I'll be able to like aim this to the point that I can hit both these targets at the same exact time. So watch this. Anything in a straight line is going to get fucked up. There we go. So killed one guy. And then we're going to use a basically hallucination makes any character I use this on start hallucinating and freaking out and kind of like attacking their own people. So I'm going to make him over here hallucinate. So he's going to start panicking, and if hopefully he starts attacking his own group of enemies. No, he doesn't. Okay, fine, fine. What we're going to do next is raise a zombie. Here we go. Let's raise the zombie, the Advent guy. Okay, that zombie is raised. I'm going to reload because I have a free reload. The free reload is due to my weapons. And then we're gonna overwatch again. See, that guy got a lot of movement. We need to debilitate this thing because the thing just seems too damn dangerous. So debilitate basically reduces its movement speed and all that stuff. I'm still not sure what to do with him. He needs to move because that's just a bad spot to be in. So first thing first, we're gonna move him back. So obviously gonna reveal him. So we're going to make her a Black Ops agent. So it says, agents of, fuck, I took the wrong thing. Oops. Right here. Wrong one. Her, that's it. So basically, soldiers gain up to 50% aim, 50 dodge, 2 additional damage for secondary weapons, and can only be used once. This skill doesn't break concealment. So basically, more power. Which is exactly what I want for her. So I want her to be able to kill all these guys at once. Like I've said before, she's technically my strongest character with these weapons, man. The sword stuff. She killed 2 of them, 1 survived.
Multiple targets neutralized.
So here's where we're gonna have to take out some enemies. Let's go over here.
The light!
So the yellow means I'm flanking them and I have a better shot. So here's the taser shot. The taser shot should shut down this thing. If I'm correct, it should shut it down for 1 turn or 2. Oh my god, I didn't even get the shutdown? Are you serious? Well, I did say should. So this guy has a stun lance. I'm very sure it's not going to do much. But we'll try it against this guy. 70% chance to hit. He only has 1 HP, so... Of course he doesn't do much. Of course this guy misses. Of course. No, go ahead. Don't hit anybody. What's the point? Yeah, you're just here for the lulz. You're just here for the lulz. Damn bastard. So I got 2 more characters I can use, so... Don't got much choice on what I could do here. So whatever. I will kill... So we're going to go to a window, hit as many people as I can at once. Let's just spin the camera around. Remember, I'm trying to protect this thing, so as much as I want to just blow this whole place open, I don't. So right here, I'm going to hit my own person, but I don't care about it. That guy's going to die anyway, so. There we go, kill 2 of them.
Anything.
All right. Insanity. Can't believe that motherfucker survived. I really can't believe that. So what's the best way to rock this right now? We're gonna do rapid fire. We're gonna go with guns. That's 9. Fuck it, let's just shoot it up.
Die.
A lot of damage. Oh, this is gonna go somewhere. Later, man. Thanks for stopping by. So he's still poisoned. He's still panicking. What the fuck is this thing about to do?
Ruins of despair!
My god, more enemies? Holy shit, man. More? I need to kill that thing immediately. And here comes the big boy. Oh crap. Okay. We gotta act a little faster. It can't be destroyed. That thing just walked in the car like it was not even there. And now it's gonna do its dumb thing that's gonna blow shit up. No, motherfucker, still watch. The snake guy still watching.
Well, they have no problem with dying.
Okay. All right then. You know what? He needs to start ripping out some damn souls, man. Like at this point, he needs to start ripping out some damn souls. Too bad robots don't have souls in this game. So I'm ripping them out. It's like, yo, no more. We're done. Fuck y'all. Alright, so. Let's try to get.
We're gonna split up.
Try frostbite. Oh, let's freeze the robot. Okay, let's freeze it. Gives me a turn not to have to deal with it. Okay, bingo. Perfect. Alright. I like this. I like where this is going. We'll put him over here. Insanity, this asshole.
Become my apprentice.
Got him all types of panic. Ruptured means that they basically are bleeding and they take more damage from later attacks. Perfect. I'm gonna poison him. I can't believe I haven't even got no drops yet, man. From all the enemies I've killed, if every one of these big guys are gonna drop me something good. Also, I know some of you guys know XCOM. If you're still wondering why the hell I got so many movements, once again, the weapon reduces my movement, but gives me a free action point. And then the colors down here. So green colors don't end your turn. It's the yellow ones or like the blue ones. It tells you exactly how it works. So once again, I even mentioned these are all mods. Like all this stuff right here, the color indications, you won't see that in the normal XCOM. Let me get a mod list going. I guess it doesn't matter. This stream would have been called Desktop for like the last 30 minutes plus, and I didn't even realize that, so yeah. Most of you guys didn't even know it was an X-Time stream. You guys just came in and just... I was wondering why people were asking what game it was. And I just realized I moved into fire.
If only
that was dumber than dumb.
So grossly incandescent.
It's alright. He'll live. Everybody just gotta go sick bay after this. Alright, let's start taking these guys out. Eat this up. Give myself some extra shield. Let's fuck this guy up. Samurai style, man. I've been even thinking about using a whole entire team of samurais because they're just so damn versatile. Oh, dude, this stupid thing survived at 1 HP. Are you serious? Slice him up again. That's why I love you having... I use that damn Shinigami shit. Get lost. Sustained. What the fuck? This thing has the ability to survive a critical hit? No, you don't. No, you do not. It basically stays... It puts itself in stasis so it doesn't die. Are you serious? Listen to the weird sound effect it makes. Alright, fine. Insanity this guy too. Mind controlled. Okay, wasn't expecting that.
Problem is solved.
Oh shit, he ruptured. Damn. Didn't expect that at all. Let's see if we can get rid of him. Though we got a good angle. He's gonna go new floor. Let's see if we can't blow this bastard up.
How's that?
Eat it. Bitch. We'll just do Shadow Wall. He's gonna be in stasis for the turn.
Your role is over.
I like the better AI. AI knows! Oh, okay, mutants? Mutons? He knows it needs backup, so just...
Spot my...
Raise a zombie, but we're not. He's carrying a bomb. So what's this mean? Fuse is an ability to basically set off a grenade on the enemy. So we know he's carrying a bomb, so now we're gonna set that grenade off. He's still be carrying a grenade. So that kind of sucks, carrying getting your own grenade blowing you up. We need to get these guys out of here because this thing is about to explode, and when it explodes,
the observer
probably gonna hurt.
Stay down.
My little joker. Little joker face right here. My medic over here. He's gonna heal himself. Alright, we could dominate him. I could show you guys what Raid Strike is. Raid Strike is basically we're running there like a big ass... Well, fuck it. Doesn't matter. Be fun. I'm gonna hurt myself doing it, but... Oh yeah, I forgot, she's immune. I forgot, so that doesn't matter. And she has the ability Deadeye due to one of her weapons things. So it actually gives you abilities on the weapons when you get dropped in the Rumi's loot mod. Alright, let's give everybody an enemy shield. We're about to wrap it up right now. We're literally just moving these guys out of the way in case when that...
Over here.
Black ball of death dies in explosion, a big ass explosion that I really wouldn't
want to kill
everybody. Now you guys might wonder why they keep the samurai there. Well, she could keep it. She's awesome. That's what she'd do. Yep, that's the shield right there.
Hostile terminated.
Okay. Well, that means that there's more enemies. Somewhere.
Moving to position.
Thought I killed everybody. We'll wait and find out.
Scanning.
In there. There's one guy hiding out. Alright, let's see how he likes a lightning bolt to the face. Fuck, I moved too far. Damn, I can't have another move. Oh, wait, yes, I can. Ah. Sometimes I forget things. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Get around it, get around it. Damn it, I don't have line of sight, so it's kind of really hard. I hope that could hit him. I don't know if it's going to hit him or not, though. Reveals him though. Can you die from the sword swing? Oh, yes you can. Flash it up time. Let's go. Let's keep our kill streak up. Bye bye, buddy.
Hostile target down.
Should be everybody.
Status confirmed.
Ooh.
All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
You made me work for that. 26 enemies plus. I don't see that many enemies in a mission, man. So that's been... Oh my god, that was... successful shot percentage, 100%. Average damage per attack, 9.7. Average enemies killed per turn. Average cover bonus. Well, before we end out this, because there's a little stream right here of that mission, I'm going to go ahead and show you guys what happens when we open up a loot pack. So let's head back to base. Oh, crap. Alright, so I'm going to have to end the stream because the game's about to freeze. What I mean by that is when you see this screen right here after you return to base, it's one of my mods. I just need to reset it. It's just like I have so many mods installed that yeah, this is a problem that does arise. I literally will just have to load back the game to a previous to one save ago and then it'll be fine. Is literally quit the game to reinstall the just restart the game. But we're just gonna go back and load back one more time and it will figure. If I tried to save the game right here, it would actually crash. I was gonna end it, but yeah, let me know guys in the comments too if you do want that full mod list. Like I said, it's over 60 mods, probably like 80, over 60. I can tell you some already. It's like Better Advent, Corrupt Avatar, Elite Viper, Advent, Titan, like Draco enemy mods, Rift Keeper, Better Advent, Mutant, Muton Creation, Alien Pack, Solia of, well, you know, the guy from Dark Souls, and I can't say his name. That guy. Alright, hold on, guys. Let's just get somebody.
Soon the rebellion will be crushed and young Skywalker will be one of us.
Let's see.
So be it.
As we already know where he is.
Status confirmed. All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Exhausting right there, guys. Alright, let's see. A little exhausting. There's actually a mod to add more stats to the screen, and I wasn't going to install it because I thought it was going to conflict with my other mods, but because I've been pretty good on not making too many conflicts, I think I'll be able to install it. Add some more detail to that screen. Okay, yeah, I gotta quit the game and reload the game for this not to happen. So yeah, guys, we'll end it right there. Yeah, I gotta quit, reload this. It's just like, one of my mods are really idiotic with that shit. Alright guys, thanks for watching. BK will be on top of the game show. I might come back with some Tales of Symphonia on the PC. I did download that and I want to try it out. So, later. Thanks for watching. BK will be on top of the game show. If you like what I do, go ahead and tip. Pretty sure I have a tip something there in the description. Somewhere down there I have that. Peace out, guys.